हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एस्पायरिंग ड्रीम सिविल सर्विसेज. हाउ यू ऑल आर डूइंग? होप सो यू आर डूइंग गुड. फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग टुडेज लेक्चर, देर इज़ वन इम्पॉर्टेंट अनाउंसमेंट. वी आर स्टार्टिंग न्यू सीरीज फॉर राइटिंग स्किल डेवलपमेंट, दैट इज़ फॉर मेन्स पेपर ऑफ UPSC, JPSC एंड BPSC एंड इवन फॉर UPPCS. सो इफ़ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड एंड यू रियली वॉन्ट टू इम्प्रूव योर राइटिंग स्किल्स, सो फास्ट ईमेल us at dreamis32@gmail.com, or for any queries related with this writing skill development program, you can email us. And this series is for 20 toppers, students first, so register fast. Now let's start with today's topic. Today's topic, I will discuss Indian economy hit one liner part 1. And Indian economy part is very important for PT as well as for mains and interview. And from Indian economy part in UPSC, around 10 to 15 questions will come, and this is based on conceptual part as well as on current affairs part. And even in HCS exam of PT, there will be 7 to 10 questions, and in BPSC and UPPCS the weightage is same. And this is very important for mains exam also, like in UPSC general studies paper 3. This is based on economy, a traditional part as well as current affairs part. So economy part is very important. So let's start with today's series. First point is NIRVIK 2020. NIRVIK scheme stand for Niryat Rin Vikas Yojana, and this scheme was announced in budget 2020 by the finance minister of India. And this scheme is based on to provide the enhanced insurance cover and to reduce the premium for the small exporters, and this is prepared by the commerce ministry. This scheme is also called as Export Credit Insurance Scheme, that is ECIS, and the insurance will be guaranteed and could cover up to 90% of the principal and interest. Earlier it was 60% loss. Next point is, what is the rank of Indian Global Economic Freedom Index 2020? So first, who released Global Economic Freedom Index? It is released by Canada's Fraser Institute. And what is the rank of India? 105. And which country is at the top list? Is Hong Kong. Next is, who appoint vice chairman of Niti Aayog? He is appointed by Prime Minister. What is Niti Aayog? Niti Aayog is National Institution for Transforming of India, and it was came in form on 1st January 2015 mein ye aaya tha. And chairman kon hota hai iska? Prime Minister is the chairman. And vice chairman is appointed by the prime minister itself. Now, next point is, how many objectives are kept in the Niti Aayog? There are 13 points of objectives which are kept in the Niti Aayog. Now, next point, what is the India's female participation in the parliament? It is 14%. This point is also very important. And which is the top country for female participation in the parliament? It is Rwanda. There 61% of the female participation in the parliament. Now, who was the first CEO of Niti Aayog? Sindhu Shri Khullar. Now, when was the Exim Bank was set up? First, what is Exim Bank? Exim Bank is Export Import Bank of India, and it was set up on 1st January 1982. And what is the main work of this bank? It offers comprehensive range of lendings and services programs to the globalization efforts of Indian companies. Now, next point is, what is the bank rate? Bank rate is a rate at which RBI give credit to the commercial bank, and there are some important rates like CRR, that is cash reserve ratio, and SLR, that is statutory liquidity ratio, is also very important for exams. CRR kya hota hai? CRR is a cash reserve ratio in which a commercial bank is required to keep some percentage of its total deposit with the Reserve Bank of India in cash only. So this is also called as cash reserve ratio. Now next is, what is frictional unemployment? This is the type of unemployment which exists in the economy due to the people are already unemployed because they are moving from one job to another. So this process is known as frictional unemployment. Now next point is, when was National Food Security Mission was launched? It was launched in 2007 to 2008, and main purpose is to increase the production of rice, wheat and pulses. Now next is central public sector enterprises are governed by which act or section? It is governed by section 135 of Companies Act of 2013 and it come under the Corporate Social Responsibility Act. Now next is Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan was launched on which date? It was launched on 12th May 2020 by Prime Minister of India, that is Narendra Modi, and he announced a special economic package of rupee 20 lakh crore which is equivalent to 10% of India's GDP to fight COVID-19 pandemic in India. So this is very important for exam. And he also outlined 5 pillars of Atmanirbhar Bharat, that is first pillar is economy, second is infrastructure, third is system, fourth is vibrant demography and fifth is demand. So this point is very important for PT as well as mains. Now next is Garib Kalyan Rojgar Abhiyan. It was launched on 20th June 2020 by PM Modi. From which district or village? It was launched in Telihar village, that is Khagaria district of Bihar. And main purpose of this Abhiyan is to empower and to provide livelihood opportunities to the migrant workers and the rural citizens of the state or country. And this campaign is to work as a mission mode for 125 days. और इसका आउटले कितना था? इट वॉज 50,000 crore. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज निष्ठा इनिशिएटिव कम अंडर विच मिनिस्ट्री? इट इज कम अंडर सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम ऑफ समग्र शिक्षा विच वॉज लॉन्च इन 2019-20 एंड द मेन एम ऑफ निष्ठा इज टू ट्रेन, टू मोटिवेट एंड टू इक्विप द टीचर्स, टू एनकरेज एंड टू फोस्टर देयर क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग इन द स्टूडेंट्स एंड हाउ टू हैंडल the diverse situations related with the education. So this is act as a first level counselor for the teachers. Now one point left, that is index of industrial production. It is released by CSO, that is Central Statistical Office of India, and this is a key economic indicator of manufacturing sector of the economy, and it is calculated on the base year of 2011-12. Next is some important committees like Arjun Sengupta committee is related with, it is related with unorganized sector, and VK Sharma committee is related with credit to marginal farmers. Now next point is National Population Register come under which ministry? It come under Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India, and it is maintained by Registrar General and Census Commissioner of India. Now next is some important term of economy, that is depression. Depression kya hota hai? It is a severe setback which is related with the business cycle where there is a widespread and some sustained unemployment. So zyada time tak agar unemployment rehti hai bahut time tak business mein, so though it is called as depression. Now next is ECS. What is ECS? ECS is electronic clearing service which is used for series of electronic payment instruction ke liye use kiya jata hai. That is for transfer of funds instead of paper instruments. So it is a mode of electronic payment instructions. So that's all for today's economy hit one liner. In next series I will cover more important points. So please keep watching and subscribe, like and share Aspiring Dream Civil Services with your friends also. Jai Hind.